Hello everyone and welcome to my gameplay of FIFA 14 on the Xbox One. Now I wanted to show you this as I wasn't expecting it to look any different, but I've come on here obviously to play it as I got it free with the download for Xbox One, and it's actually quite a lot different to what I was expecting. I was expecting all of the windows to stay the same on their colours to stay the same. I was just sort of expecting the gameplay and the graphics to be improved a little bit, but it's actually been changed a reasonable amount, as you can see, the colours and everything. And obviously I've got a different team to what I did have on the 360. I sold that in a rage sale. I got a bit annoyed with it, so I thought now's a good time to show off my new team. Decent Prem team. Check the fitness, you know what? And I thought, to christen off the Xbox One and FIFA 14, I might as well play an online game with it. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to play an online single game. Probably going to get absolutely hammered, but I'm not too worried. I want to sort of show off the graphics and the gameplay. I've not played a game on it yet, so I don't know if it's feeling any different or not. I'm hoping it feels better to what it does on the 360, as I wasn't really too impressed with that, to be quite honest. FIFA 12 was brilliant, FIFA 13 came out and I was a little disappointed, and then FIFA 14 came out, I saw that the single games are back and I had high hopes for it, but I'm really disappointed again with it. I'm probably not even going to be able to find a game, to be quite honest. A lot of people probably don't have the Xbox One, or I'm guessing a lot of people that have the Xbox One are amazing, so I'm going to get absolutely annihilated. But yeah, as I said, I'm not too worried. I sort of just want to show you guys the graphics, the gameplay, and what's changed on it. Now, first thing is, everything does seem a lot clearer colour-wise. The clarity of it is quite a lot different. I mean, you didn't used to be able to pick up the colour differences so much with the 360, whereas this is, in places, it's a lot more sharper than others, and I'm not sure whether it'll be able to pick it up once I've rendered it down or everything and everything. But once again, like Rice, this is a very good high quality game, and I think my Kinect is actually picking me up talking, but I don't care. Right, okay, so hopefully the game on this will be good. Graphics definitely look better, and it feels a lot better. As I said on the 360, when I did the demo game for it, it did feel a lot heavier, whereas on this it is, it feels very agile again, and how FIFA 12 used to feel, because, I mean, as FIFA 13 came out, it gradually felt a lot heavier, and it just sort of wasn't, the players didn't seem anywhere near as agile as they did. And then when this came out, there was a big difference. I mean, you could feel the difference between 13 and 14, let alone if you went from this and then to play number 12. Ooh, you know, I better mute my mic, actually. I don't even know how to do this. How do I mute the Kinect? I can't. Bollocks. Right, that I feel sorry for that dude who's going to be listening to me yapping on the whole way through. So, good idea. You know, I'll plug my headset in, and then I'll mute the headset. Boom. That's a good idea. Okay, yeah, so let's get back onto this. Mute. There we go. Done. Hopefully that's done. Yeah, so I've played a couple of games with this team on the 360, and they don't seem too bad to play with. Definitely a different feel to my Serie A team, but obviously the play style's a lot different in the Prem team, so the stats are all equaled out differently. It feels like they try and make a run a bit more and try and get up front, whereas the Serie A team sort of gradually built up, and that is something with the Italian teams. They do, once again, like the Spanish league, have quite slow build-up play at times. But, oh, shizer. This team, Prem team, feels so good. I mean, the reason I didn't start with a Prem team is because the players were unbelievably overpriced. I love that with the kits. How cool do the kits look now? All the creases on the shirts. Yeah, the grass looks good close up. it just obviously there's, even though it's just sort of little differences here and there, it just makes a big change to the game in total. The same with the audience. I mean, it's nice to see a decent audience at long last without having the same people in the same shirts all jumping at the same time. It just small things like that, the detail to the background improves the game to me. So I'm pleased about that. I mean, obviously now it's got a new processor and graphics and everything. It's a lot easier to be able to have a game processing that, especially as it installs onto the console. Don't have to worry about it lagging or anything, because obviously it's installed, so it gets the data a lot quicker, same as games that are on the PC. Obviously graphics will always be best on the PC, so I suppose obviously with it being Microsoft, they've tried their best to sort of try and get near to the PC graphics. Obviously it's quite a long distance away, but it's a lot better than what it used to be. And I mean, this is release games as well. As time goes on, new I like that, the run in there looks pretty cool. As new games come out, and probably new Xbox Ones that get released, with like Xbox One Slims, as they always do, everything will improve once again. So it's nice to see that a game is really high graphics and quality, even in the beginning stages of the next generation console. So I'm quite looking forward to seeing what's going to happen over the next couple of years. I mean, Destiny is a game I'm really looking forward to seeing what could happen to that. I mean, the graphics I can imagine are going to be amazing. They've been working on it for a long time, and it is a big file, and it's just a lot of effort has gone into it in detail, so I'm very looking forward to seeing what that's going to turn out like. I think I've got auto switch on for my team, so I'm going to need to take that off as soon as I get the ball back again. I'm not used to playing auto switch. Let's have a look. Settings, control settings, air balls only. There we go. That's what I want. Now let's get back to the game and talking about what's different and what's new. All the legends have been released now, and I was hoping with the release day pack that I got, I was going to get someone decent. Turns out I can't sell any of the people I got in that pack, which sucks really, because if I did get a legend player, then that would have been gutting, because I wouldn't have been able to sell him. I mean, I wouldn't have wanted to keep the legend players, just because sort of they wouldn't blend in with the team very well. I'd have to build a squad around them, whereas with a Prem team, not too many English players are in it that I've got. So if I did get like an English legend, it would have been a bit useless to me. Whereas if I got a goalkeeper, I suppose it wouldn't have been too bad. Van der Sar wouldn't have done much difference to the chemistry style, and he's an absolutely amazing keeper, my favourite keeper of all time. Not just because I am a United supporter, but the fact that he was world class, brilliant keeper. So I was quite pleased to see that he's on the game. So hopefully I might be able to sort of get pick a couple of decent legends up and manage to fit him in my team somehow. But time will tell. I'm more interested in the informs and teams of the seasons, players, etc., etc. So man of the matches as well. I mean, get some decent man of the match cards. But I'm not going to be able to play one game for a long period of time. I'm going to want to switch between different games, because I'm just going to be playing this game for half hour, and then I'm going to be like, oh, I want to go on to this one. So I'm going to be switching around a lot, and I am going to have a lot of different series up on my channel. I'm not going to sort of just concentrate with one game. I've always liked the idea of doing different things, trying to cater for different subscribers. So I am going to be doing all different kinds of series. I apologise if sometimes I'll do like a video and then won't upload the following one to it for like a few days or whatever, but I'm just trying to do a channel where I can keep loads of people happy. I mean, I'm a very small channel at the minute. I'm hoping to build. I do love my game, and I love making videos for YouTube. I've always enjoyed doing it. I had my old channel just doing Minecraft, and I mean, I used to get excited just to get a video done, because I could only record once a day with the laptop I had, because it was so bad. But I finally got all my gaming setup complete, as I promised I would, and now I'll get all the videos done. I can properly do all the editing and everything, so hopefully I'll be able to build my channel up bigger, because I love getting the comments from you guys. I love making videos that you enjoy, and it's just something I've always enjoyed doing. I get so excited to play new games or to get series done, because it's just the best hobby I've ever come across. I mean, a lot of you people will probably agree, but then I also know a lot of people that just find gaming a waste of time, and it's just like, whatever. I can't even be bothered to sort of argue with them, because two completely different opinions. I find gaming a more interactive thing to do, whereas instead of watching TV like a lot of people do, I'd much rather play a game, being able to watch a storyline to it and also interact at the same time. So definitely the best thing, I find. And also there's achievements to do, you can set yourself goals, so it's just something I really enjoy, and I'm going to be continuing with this, so gradually I should hopefully grow, and hopefully I'll find a lot of videos that will help you guys out as well. I mean, the most viewed video I've got at the minute on my channel is like 700 views, and that's one of the skill lob pass challenges, and I was quite impressed that I managed to find out how to do that, to be quite honest. And I was quite shocked of how many views I've got on it as well. I was not expecting it to go up that quickly. So I will try, and obviously if I find out how to do something that a lot of people are struggling with, I'll show you guys the technique that I've got, and hopefully it'll help you guys out, like the other one did. Now, I've come close to scoring twice. I can't get over the graphics on this. They're amazing. I do like it. Come on. I'd love to win this, I must say. I would love to win it. I've never been a great FIFA player, admittedly. But I wouldn't say I'm the worst. I was not expecting to, would not be expecting to win on this, as the majority of people that have an Xbox One are obviously YouTube gamers or heavy gamers, people that play it a lot, whereas I'm being a FIFA fan, I'll sort of do it when I'm bored of another game. I wouldn't say I'm addicted to FIFA. I mean, I can take it or leave it. I do rage a lot of FIFA, but I do enjoy it at the same time. But obviously there's a hell of a lot of better people, a hell of a lot of better players out there than me, so not expecting to win this, but I mean, it would be really good if I do win this. It would be sort of first game on FIFA and the Xbox One, christen it with a win. I'd be quite pleased. But I'm trying not to get my hopes up, because I don't particularly want to rage in this video. I'm very tired, and I don't want to be raging too much. I want to try and keep my energy for the rest of the day of recording I've got ahead of me. And goal, there we go. Brilliant. Gonna keep my cool, I don't even care, you know what. I hope the celebrations don't last too long, because sometimes they do get a little bit annoying. Right, once again, sweaty crosses, brilliant. Always love headers, always been great at them. Oh dear, 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 dear. Dude, how many times? I hope they haven't given the ability to be able to watch the replay like 100 times. Because this, if you play against someone who's going to score like 15 goals against you, then you're going to be utterly screwed. You're going to be there for like an hour if they're a troll. And no, my luck, I will have someone like that. Right, anyway, let's try and get a comeback on. Now, yeah, I do want to get a few different players for this team. I had a budget to stick with, so I've not been able to pick the best players that I wanted. I've had to make do with a few to start off with. I've not got a number of subs either. I've got to try and save a few coins up. Obviously, I've got my series that I'm doing to Road to... Oh, come on, I thought I had that. Road to Division 1. So I will get a few thousand off of that, but I mean, some of the players I want are quite a bit of money, so I've got to try and do myself a little bit of trading, and I'll probably do, obviously, a few tournaments on and offline. Now, if I could try and get past there. Come on, please. Come on. This will be a good goal. God, no. Come on. I've got to put one away, surely. Keep coming close. There we go. Thank goodness. Let's see if the shushing is there. There it is. Right, he made me watch 2 million replays. Let's shush him and then make him not talk. Well, actually, no, probably be raging. I'm just glad I've not got my headset. No, I've got my headset plugged in now. I'm glad he can't hear me through the Kinect. Just insulting him. Okay, so I can score against him. I'm going to go ultra defensive and I'm going to try and do it again. Now, another big thing about this is I love the controls. The control feels amazing. And I like the fact that you haven't got the charge pack hanging out the back now. It feels a lot more comfortable to hold it as the controls are a lot more slender. But at the same time, it's still chunky. Because that's what I don't like about the PlayStation 4 controls are the PlayStation 3 and 4. I find there's not much space for my hand. I find that that my hand's a bit too close together, so that's why I do like this control. I'm pleased about it. I was thinking, oh, great, a change, it might decrease my popularity for it, but it's actually increased it, so I can't moan at the control. Now, what's the other thing I was going to say? He's left-footed. There was something else I was going to say about the control, but I can't remember. Oh, that's it. My Xbox 360 control I did have, oops, I didn't mean to do that, had a broken analog stick. So, if I was playing like Call of Duty or something, my players would be slowly walking forward as the spring was gone on it. But I'm so pleased, now I've got this control, finally got one that's working, and it's a day one control, so it's got day one written on the middle of it, and that looks pretty cool. Also will probably be worth a hell of a lot of money in years and years to come, so well worth the investment, I think. So I'm overall very pleased with this, and FIFA's feeling a lot better. I mean, I was on a proper rage with it last night. Every time someone said it to me, I was like, don't swear at me. But it feels a lot better and feels a lot less broken than FIFA 14 on the 360 did. It just didn't feel right for some reason, but whereas on this, the players feel like they're listening to you a lot more. They're sort of taking in what controls you're pressing a lot quicker. They're just responding to you a lot better than what they previously did, and I find that as they didn't respond like straight away to whatever controls you're pressing or anything like that, it made them make a lot of errors, like bad touches or giving the ball away, just to, and stuff like that can make you lose the game. So I'm pleased with this. I mean, as I said, it is quick responding, and I'm enjoying it. So I'm very pleased about that. I wasn't expecting to play FIFA and say I'm enjoying it. That is something I've not been expecting to do for a long time. So yes, I'm pleased with that as well. I mean, Son of Rome, brilliant. This, I'm not going to say brilliant, as it's only one game, but it feels good, and it looks good as well, so can't moan at that. And obviously, the look of it as well, like, oh, the look of it, the windows where they've changed the colour and everything, that I like the look of that as well. I wasn't expecting that all to change. So it's sort of had quite a bit of a refurb compared to what it was like on the on the Elite, on the 360 even, because it'll be the same on the arcade and everything. So yeah, a lot of work's gone into it, and I know a lot of people did say it was going to feel different on the Xbox One, and I wasn't sure if it was going to or not, and it does. So if you wanted that confirmed, there it is. And oh my gosh, I've done it. I've got. Well, I'm not going to lose, put it that way. I'm not going to say it's the winner, touch wood, but 3 minutes left of the game. Hopefully that is the winner. I'll be pleased if it is. I'd love to christen this game off with a win. It'll make me speechless. I was not expected. I was expecting to come into this to like a 5-6-0 loss, and it to be pretty embarrassing. And seeing as I'm winning 2-1 with... I'm just going to hold this, sorry, very, really, really newbie, but seeing as I'm winning this whilst recording as well and talking, it sort of made me feel pretty impressed with myself. Maybe I'm better than I was expecting. But better not speak too soon, because no my luck. Oh, thank God for that. Yep, right, okay, decent. I win. And so, recap. Audience, good. Shirts, look at that. Brilliant. And when you saw Huntelaar's goal, the grass going up into the air, brilliant. That, the cars and everything. Obviously, it's a bit boxy, but I mean, it's just still adding a little bit of detail to the game, showing the stadium from the outside view. So, all in all, brilliant game. Not as good as Rice, Son of Rome, but that is probably because that is a new game to me, and I'm sort of in a bit of a hype with that at the minute. Whereas FIFA, I've been playing this for years and years now, so it sort of gets same old, but I am pleased that the graphics has been improved, and also the game feels a lot better than it did. So I'm going to leave it there, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. I will be back again soon with more. And if you did enjoy this, do leave a like, and do subscribe, as I'll be uploading a lot more Xbox One gameplays and videos, and I'll be back again soon more. Cheers for watching, speak to you all again soon, bye bye.